Hi, I'm Anna Steinbauer. Welcome to this workshop. I started sketching a few ideas because the brief for this painting was relatively open and free, so I just want to explore what I could possibly be doing. I do this with a very simple line brush on a lightly textured background because I feel that this really simulates drawing on paper a bit for me. I make quite a few of those little drawings. They're very rough, but they're enough to give me an idea of what the painting might look like. Once I have a couple, I pick my four favorites and try to fit them within the ImagineFX cover template. And then I start adding some color. I really feel like painting something with very strong blues and maybe turquoise or purple, so that's pretty much what guides my color choices in all of this. Normally I would probably be working in black and white at this stage, just to really establish the values. But the only requirement that ImagineFX gave me for this painting was that it was going to be something very colorful. So I really wanted to reflect that within the sketches. I wanted to show them that each one of these concepts could potentially be something very colorful. I also really want to try and make sure that I'm not playing favorites at this point. I like each and every one of these sketches, and I want to make sure that each one of them would be something that I would enjoy painting, because right now I don't know which one the client is going to choose. So after sending the sketches to the client, this is the one they picked, which I'm quite happy with. I quite enjoy the movement of this one. The only thing they asked for is to make the colors a little stronger. Usually the colors I pick tend to be a little more desaturated, but since this is a cover image, I understand that we want it to be a very striking image color-wise. So I upped the colors using various overlay layers and just strengthening the turquoises and the pinks, making sure we have some nice warm lighting coming in, contrasting all the blue. And I'm also strengthening the values overall a bit to add a little more contrast, which the image needed anyway. Now that the colors are established, I finally get to start painting. I like to start on the face because it's my favorite thing to paint. It just really gets me in the groove. And also I feel like when I have an okay looking face in a painting, it just makes me feel like working on the painting a lot more. I like really taking my time with faces, making sure they end up looking good, because as people, we are very focused on other people's faces, just by nature. And when there's a face in an image, we'll look at it, and we'll look at it closely. So when painting faces, I really like to spend as much time as they need, to look good, even if it's a lot of time, and just basically giving them the attention they need. At this point, I'm flipping my painting to make sure that everything is looking right so far. flipping your image really helps you get a fresh eye on things and maybe spot mistakes that you would have otherwise missed. So flipping your painting frequently throughout the painting process is a good idea, but be careful not to do it too often. Because if you do that, you run the risk of getting used to both versions, both the flipped and the regular version, and then the whole effect of flipping your image is basically gone. So flip your image occasionally, but be sure not to do it too often. Occasionally, I'm comparing what I'm painting right now to the sketch. I really want to make sure that the essence of the sketch, or what I personally saw in the sketch, really gets translated into the painting. And sometimes, well, I feel like I didn't do such a good job of it, so this is why I'm using Free Transform Warp here to adjust the overall size of the face, some parts of the face as well. I'm just generally trying to make it look a little nicer. And finally, the face looks okay enough to move on to the rest of the image. I always like taking the face about halfway or 80% of the way and then move on to the rest of the image so I don't forget about that. So I start working on the body, painting in the basic lighting and slowly getting rid of the sketch on top. I feel like my colors are looking a little flat, so I adjust them a bit using a curves layer. You just go to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, Curves. Once I'm happy with what I achieved with the curves layer, it's time to adjust the values a bit, and I like doing that manually. I make a new layer, set it to overlay, make it a clipping mask to the layer with the character on it, and then I paint over it with a brownish color to darken her a bit, give her skin a little more color. the water is still looking kind of lame at this point, and I feel like this is the next place I need to work on. I go online and Google a couple of images of random ocean waves, and I study them closely. I look at a lot of pictures and just try to understand how they work, where the colors appear, where which colors appear, where they're more blue, where they're more turquoise, that sort of thing. And I look at these images and I study them, and then I close all those images. So basically, I don't have any direct reference open while I'm painting this. All the reference comes now from within my memory, from the things I just saw. That way I feel like I'm going to retain more of it for the future. So next time I paint waves, I might not need to look at reference at all. And I highly, highly recommend that you try this as well. It's a great way to learn new things while you're painting stuff from your imagination. occasionally when I feel like I've exhausted what I had in my memory from before, I go back, look at another few references, and then close them again and repeat the process. That way I feel like I keep learning new things and keep building on what I remembered before. And it really feels so much nicer than following a reference image, or even just loosely following a reference image. Obviously, the ideal way to really retain all the information that I'm gaining from these images is to do a study of one of them. So basically, take one of these images, try to copy it as closely as I can, and then close both of those images and go paint my image. But since there is a deadline to this, I don't have that much time to do studies besides painting this. So this method I just described to you of looking at images, closing them, and then trying to apply what you learned from memory is somewhat of a shortcut to doing proper studies and then applying them. But again, ideally you would be doing the proper studies. I'm just telling you about this little exercise I do when there's not that much time because there's a deadline. I could just keep painting and keep adding those little waveforms by hand, but I feel it would be much smarter and much easier to just use a texture brush, so that's what I do. I just make a basic texture with a brush and then transform it to match the waves. when working on a painting, I always like to think about what is the next thing that I need to do to make the image feel more finished. And at this point, that is definitely the fish, because they're just really shapeless blobs at this point. The next thing I really need to work on is her hair, or well, the fins that she has on her head that are kind of arranged like hair. Well, at this point it's looking kind of stupid because it looks like it's only growing out from the top of her head. So I add a couple more fins in the back to make sure the mohawk shape really reads. Because this is what I intended in the sketch, but then it kind of got lost as I was painting. with all those bright saturated colors, and especially the pinks, the image is feeling a little too sweet for my taste. And I really want to toughen the girl a bit up, so I feel like I can achieve that by maybe darkening her lips, so that's what I try. And I really feel it adds something. And as I give her this darker lipstick, I feel like, well, maybe a Maori-inspired chin tattoo would look kind of cool, so that's what I'd try and add as well. And I kind of like it, so it stays. So following that general guideline that I mentioned before of asking yourself, what do I need to paint next to make the image feel more finished? I feel like the next thing is the accessories on her outfit, because no one but me at this point can tell what they're supposed to be. It's just very rough doodles, and I know they're supposed to be shells and teeth and bones, but no one else does. So that's what I need to work on. the next thing I need to start working on is the staff, because right now it's still super, super rough. And again, no one would be able to tell what this is, no one but me. So I start playing around with some shapes. I want to make sure that the shape of the shell at the tip works with the composition. So these spikes here that I'm painting, they all point very much into the image rather than out of it. As you can see, the tip of the staff is cropped off the canvas. It might be a bit of an unusual decision, but I quite like it because I feel it adds a lot of motion to the image. Sort of as if the photographer wasn't quite able to move fast enough to capture the entire thing and just focused on his focal point, which is the character. And well, the staff got cropped off, but that's fine because it's not that important anyway. If I had left it within the image, the tip of the staff would have become quite important, would have probably become a secondary focal point. But I asked myself, why would I want that? What does it tell us? It doesn't really tell us anything. We can tell she controls water somehow. So showing her magical staff in greater detail really isn't all that necessary. And as I said, it's mainly a decision for adding a little more motion to this composition. now that the image is getting more and more rendered, a lot of mistakes are becoming more obvious that I didn't quite notice in my sketch. Or maybe there are areas that I misinterpreted in the sketch and just took them a little the wrong way in the painting. So I fixed those and work on the body a bit more. Now that I think about it, I don't really like that the stick part of the staff is made of a different material as the tip. So basically the stick right now is wood, maybe some driftwood that she picked up, and the tip is a shell. But I decided that it would be cooler to have the entire staff be made out of shell, as if it's a magically warped shell that just magically turned into a staff form. Luckily, I wrote a to-do list early on because I almost forgot to do this part of the painting. I really wanted to add this effect that light makes when it gets refracted by the waves and water, this ripply water effect. I think it's so pretty, so I thought this would be a perfect opportunity to add it. Also, it would lighten the shadow side of her body a bit and just add a little more interest to the image. So I just draw in the basic shapes that the ripples are going to make. As I'm doing this, I'm careful to follow the shapes of her body with it and make sure that I can enhance the foreshortening with that effect wherever possible. And once I'm happy with how the shapes look, I erase them a bit in some parts and make them fainter. Then I make another layer and add a little more turquoise light overall. And I just keep on layering this until it looks good to me. Once everything is painted, I really want the cloth and her skin to look a little wet, so I draw in some specular highlights for shininess. Now there are only a few tiny things left to do. I noticed that the fish's fins in the foreground are making tangents with the waves behind them, so I paint around on the waves a bit to fix that. There are a few areas in the background where I still want to touch up the colors a bit and maybe smudge some areas that were a little too sharp. And now we're nearing the end of the painting. So thank you very, very much for watching this really, really long video. And I really hope you enjoyed watching me paint this.